What's up, everyone? So, since the last video that I made, Uchiliki, who has could have done this at any point in time the past like 2 3 weeks, decided to start like clipping my videos again and yelling at me because Uchiliki's someone who is one in Tiffany's circle, and they're just trying to get me attention for all this bullshit that's going on. So. Probably what happened is Stephanie finally calmed the fuck down because now that I yelled back at her enough and she yelled back at me enough, and okay, so Cernovich and Don Jr. now are talking about spiritual shit. Thank you guys, because I'm not trying to do an act or sell anything. This is just kind of how I am, good and or bad or all of it. That's just what I do. And if you want to take it from here and for the clicks and the views, more power to you. I have to finish my taxes. I need to start doing my labs and my practice quizzes. And I'm going to I'm not. If she wouldn't have stolen the money, I probably would be retired. But I'm not retired yet. So this is what you do when you're not retired. If you're successful, at least, or something like that. I don't spend all day long podcasting and watching other podcasts and all that bullshit. What I will do is I will show you a secret of mine. People are like, "How come you're so difficult? How come you're so hard to understand?" I will show you one of my secrets of how I don't put up with anyone's bullshit. You want to know what I do all day sometimes? Let me put on my meditation music too. All right, hold on. Let me show you what I do sometimes all day. This is what I do sometimes all day.
From the field of the future, a new king will come to save the world of the past.
In the near future, Doc Terror and his cyborg companion Hacker unleash their forces to conquer Earth. Only one force can stop this evil, a handful of brave men. In specially created exoframes, they can be transported anywhere to fuse with incredible assault weapon systems, beamed down from the space station Sky Vault, becoming man and machine, power extreme. Max Ray, brilliant sea operations commander. Jake Rockwell, rugged land operations specialist. Ace McCloud, daring air operations expert.
You only think I missed. It's a heat-seeking missile.
Whatever the challenge, they are ready. The Centurions.
What else is a good one? Ooh, Robotech.
Yeah.
I want to point something out. diversity woke bullshit. Reagan really was a moderate because all the diversity bullshit, the reason why they have to take it to the extreme is because in the 80s, they got equality. And if your goal is social change or getting money, you don't want equality. You, as Thomas Sowell says, you just want more. Anyways, I'm a giant nerd. I've watched all of these Robotechs. I've even seen the one where Rick Hunter gets married to Lisa, the army bitch, instead of to Min-May because she's always being a cunt. We'll watch that one next. And then she's like, I realized only when he's getting married to some other bitch that I really love him. And it's like, yeah, you shouldn't have been a flaky bitch the whole time. Anyways, but no, this is Lancer. Lancer is a Blair White trans. Yep, because, in the comics and in the anime, there's like a female pop star after the apocalypse, and everyone's like in love with the female pop star, and I think it's this dude, like, falls in love with her with like the dress on, and then like he's like, no, I'm really a dude and I just put this on because it's how I feel inside. And they're like, well, do you want to come with us and like save the planet or just hang out here? And it's like, next act, the Lancer is joining the team. But like Lancer pretty much is fucking like androgynously, like whoever will get some, Lancer's gonna give it to him, is pretty much how it goes. Oh yeah, but no, again, so all that agenda bullshit, equality in the 80s. It's kind of like in Ninja Scroll when the bitches are like, what is it? Just watch Ninja Scroll and you'll understand. Yeah, actually, I don't want to watch all that other bullshit. I just want to keep doing what I like to do. What else is there? Galdar. Thundar. No. Thundar the Barbarian. Whatever the bullshit is.
Thundar the Barbarian! The year 1994. From out of space comes a runaway planet hurtling between the Earth and the Moon, unleashing cosmic destruction. Man's civilization is cast in ruin. 2,000 years later, Earth is reborn. A strange new world rises from the old. A world of savagery, super science, and sorcery. But one man bursts his bonds to fight for justice. With his companions, Ookla the Mock and Princess Ariel, he pits his strength his courage, and his fabulous sun sword against the forces of evil. He is Thundar, the Barbarian.
All right, we're going to go out with a bang. This is going to be the last one. That's awesome. That's awesome. I want to see that again. That is totally awesome. That's all the TV I need. All right, I have to get my taxes done and all that bullshit. I just feel like all this was planned and I'm somehow still being manipulated by Stephanie, but I still need to get my taxes done.